So you should be able to go up front and record now.
Oh, okay. Well, it's nice. I have a space here. So it's something to do. I just haven't zoomed in a little bit. Also, we've had video cameras installed at the three doors, the two small doors in the hallway, from the courtyard in and from the back into the office, and down from the kitchen. And they will be notifying the secretary or the preschool director when somebody comes to the door, because all the doors are locked when preschool is here. There are no online doors. So if we look at the announcements for today, we want to go through, we had a personnel meeting this morning. The hymn sing for this afternoon has been canceled. Choir practice is in the sanctuary on Tuesday evenings. Beth is always looking for new members. We're up to six now, and so that's exciting. And so we'll go from there. 8A Basics is on Friday night. The Penn Northeast Conference is having a meeting here, their fall meeting, on Saturday morning. And they are doing everything live here for about 40 people, but across the conference via Zoom. Faith formation classes are next Sunday at 9 a.m. And what was the attendance this morning, Beth?
For, gosh, I'm not sure.
Maybe. I probably saw maybe 9, 10?
Yes.
Which is great, because that's a big step for us in
faith formation, which is Sunday school. Next Sunday, worship is at 10 a.m. Budget form is at 11 a.m. This morning, in the back, in the narthex, there were three forms to be handed out. The narrative budget, the actual number budget, and then the constitutional change that we need to talk about. So please review those. If you have any questions, please ask. We will be available today after church in the front here for anybody with questions. And we want all the questions asked before next Sunday when it's voted on. So, let's see here. The budget form will be held next Sunday following the meeting. A congregational meeting will be held Sunday, November 15th following worship. All members are asked to attend, and that's when we'll approve all of this. We are collecting 200 cases of corn for Thanksgiving. I see quite a bit up here. We need to get on the move because next week is the last Sunday for collecting corn for Thanksgiving. And it's for the Northern Lehigh Food Bank. Flowers and the bulletin sponsors are needed. Please see the flower and bulletin calendar in the back. And if you need to order flowers immediately for any reason, please call the church office. Office hours are Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday from 10 a.m. to 2 p.m. And the secretary can get your order placed. Valor monthly dinners will be delivered. Last Sunday, they delivered some up. And they did not stay to serve them because everything's prepackaged according to the specs. Backpack Buddies, our mission team hopes to continue to collect items to donate to Backpack Buddies. And they're going mostly to students in the Slatington School District who are in need of things. With the pandemic, a lot of these students aren't getting the required meals and they aren't getting the required things that they need to protect themselves. Confirmation class, a new class has been formed. 13 members, 7 females, 6 male. We have sponsors for all the 7 females. But we need male sponsors for the males. It's a huge class. I don't know when we had a class this large last. It's been a few years at least. Mission team is collecting new blankets for the homeless, and they're also collecting mittens, hats, gloves, and scarves, and they can be placed on the tree in the narthex. Mary, I think you have something you want to say.
First of all, next Sunday, eat a light breakfast so that when you leave church, you're going to be hungry. Our youth group is going to be selling a whole little lunch for you. For $5, you will have a 6-inch sub, and you have a choice of ham or turkey, and you also have a bag of chips and a cookie in there. So that's your lunch for $5. And we ask you to support us if you can. The proceeds from that are going to the Bethany Children's Home to help with that offering that we'll be taking later on. And second of all, we do have a youth group meeting today right after church down in the fellowship hall.
Thank you, Mary. Any other announcements for the good of the church? I have a few other things here. Joyful noise, since we're not passing the buckets, there is joyful noise receptacles in the narthex. The coins can be tossed in the water. And I had somebody recommend that we put a shot glass in there, and once your coin goes in the shot glass, somebody will triple the bad amount. So, we talked about the faith formation gifts for Bethany. There's cash donation box in the back, and this is besides what the Youth Fellowship is doing. We now have transmitters. Anybody need a portable transmitter for their car or to sit in here and listen to the service, and they are hard to hear. They're free for the asking. A donation by an anonymous person was given, and we have many of these to hand out. Thank you. Confirmation Sunday will be held on the 29th, and that will be another communion service. And the votive stand here is for you to please light a candle in memory or honor of loved ones. Any other announcements? Let's prepare our hearts for the worship of God. Thank you. Mm-hmm.
you for joining us here at Good Shepherd United Church of Christ, Slatington. Today, we look at the Beatitudes and how we might find comfort in these words of wisdom. We also are called to remember those who have been part of our journey in this world, members of this faith community, and those who have touched our lives through our celebration of Tobit Fest. As we begin, I would like to ask, normally we have a time for blessings, for joys or concerns, but because we don't come forward, I would ask if there are any joys or concerns that you would like to lift up from where you're at. If not, if you would all bow your heads and receive this blessing. Holy and gracious one, we give you thanks for all your blessings, that you might continue to fill us with your goodness and mercy so that we might go forth and share that same goodness and mercy with others, so that we might find our way home to your heart in Jesus Christ. For it is in that precious name we pray, and let the people of God say, Amen. At this time, it has been the tradition at Good Shepherd that we remember those of our church family who have parted from this world and have entered into the church triumphant. And we have a number of people that we would like to remember. For those of you who have loved ones who were not part of our congregation that has passed, I would invite you at some time during the service to come up and light one of the candles in our votive stand. When I call your loved one's name, if a member of the family or the family would come forward, there's a white rose that you can take from the vase, place it on the altar. Our acolyte will be holding the candlestick and will hand it to you, and you can light one candle. After the candle's been lit, handed back to the acolyte, you will wipe it down for the next person. And this way we can maintain some semblance of social distancing. So at this time, I would like to begin with this prayer. Holy and gracious one, we thank you for the gifts that you have given us and the relationships that make our lives more full. You remind us that you have created us to love and to be loved. And now, as we remember our sisters and brothers in faith who have entered into your glory, we pray for those who remain behind, that you might continue to bless them with memories and with the knowledge of that same love. For it's in that love of Jesus Christ we pray. Amen. Dominic Matthew Horvath, born into this world January the 6th, 1996, entered into everlasting life on November the 7th, 2019. He was aged 23 years. Richard Kenneth Gruber entered this life November the 9th, 1967. Entered eternal life on December the 27th, 2019, at the age of 52. Thank you. Sylphie's new heart paws. Entered this world on June 16, 1923. Was received into the presence of her Lord on January 9, 2020. Age 96 years. Christy Lee DeLong Richardson. Born February 8, 1983. And entered into eternal life on March the 7th, 2020. Aged 37 years. Brenda Helen Fatzinger Horn. Born into this world October the 24th, 1951. And entered into eternal glory of her Lord on May the 4th, 2020. Aged 68 years. Carolyn Louise Hunts Dietrich Mann. Born July the 28th, 1943. Entered eternal life May the 24th, 2020. Aged 76 years. Gracious One, you remind us all that from dust we came and to dust we shall return. And during this journey here on earth, you give us opportunities to share the experiences that life has for us. We are grateful for these individuals who have been a part of this congregation, who have shared both joys and sacrifices, who have continued to be guides to those who they love so dearly and who love them. Holy One, we've commended them to your care, and now we pray that you help us here on earth to support one another as we continue to walk this journey of faith until that day when we close our eyes to this world and open them to the world you have promised in Jesus Christ, so that we might see our loved ones again in that place of perfect peace, where death will be no more, nor sorrow or tears. For these things we thank you in Jesus' name. And let the people of God say, one of the things that unify us is our faith in what we believe. And so I would invite you to join me in stating what we believe is found in the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, the maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only begotten Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Ghost, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead, and buried. He descended into hell. On the third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and sitteth on the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence he shall come to judge the quick and the dead. I believe in the Holy Ghost, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. The gospel lesson for this morning comes from Matthew, the 22nd chapter, which we know well as the Beatitudes. When Jesus saw the crowds, he went up the mountain, and after he sat down, his disciples came to him. Then he began to speak and taught them, saying, "Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are those who mourn, for they will be comforted. Blessed are the meek, for they will inherit the earth. Blessed are those who hunger and thirst for righteousness, for they will be filled. Blessed are the merciful, for they will receive mercy. Blessed are the pure in heart, for they will see God. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they will be called children of God. Blessed are those who are persecuted for righteousness' sake, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are you when people revile you and persecute you and utter all kinds of evil against you falsely on my account. Rejoice and be glad, for your reward is great in heaven. For in the same way, they persecuted the prophets who were before you." The Gospel of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Amen. Let us pray. Holy and gracious one, we come to this moment, and we ask that you might open our hearts and our minds to wrestle with these words and to try to find meaning, so that you might help us to be able to live this life you call us to with your integrity and your grace. For it's in that precious name of Jesus Christ, our Lord, who shows us a new way. Amen. So, the lesson today about Beatitudes is not an easy one. You see, the Beatitudes have all these strange things. Blessed are those who mourn. Really? It doesn't feel like you're blessed when you lose somebody that you love. Blessed are they who are persecuted. Really? I don't like to get bullied or criticized, do you? So what does this thing that Jesus is trying to teach his disciples? And I think it's important that we recognize that he's talking to those who have chosen to follow him. You know, for many years, I was under the impression that the word blessed, in this case, refers to being happy. And I think that's part of the reason why I have such a hard time thinking that people who are struggling, hungering for righteousness, trying to do their best, how they can be happy in that. Especially in light of gathering today on this Totenfest, when we come still with heavy hearts and missing people that so many have loved, and we're to say you should be happy. But a truer translation of the Hebrew word for blessed is actually, you're on the right road. So Jesus says, you know, those people who mourn are on the right road, for they will be comforted. Then I started to apply that to what I have seen in the various situations, not only this past year, but throughout my ministry, throughout the history of the church, in fact. When somebody dies, there's a community of sisters and brothers of faith who gather to grieve with. When we gather to celebrate weddings, and the number of weddings I've done, yesterday was another. Eddie and Karen, if you're somewhere in the house, oh, right up here. Boy, you should see Karen, she really gets down. Their granddaughter got married yesterday. And guess what? Because of our faith in God through Jesus Christ, there are brothers and sisters to celebrate with us and support us in those joys. So I began to think about that in light of something that I found that I'd like to read to you. It goes as follows. Jesus looked around at many of his friends who had gathered on the hillside and thought this would be a good time to tell my friends what it means to be a disciple. Friends, when you see someone hungry, know that God blesses them. God doesn't want anyone to be hungry. Share your food with others. When you see someone sad, know that God blesses them. God wants to help their sadness go away. Please help others who are feeling sad. When you see someone who wants to know more about God, know that God blesses them. God wants to help everyone know more about God's way. Be kind and loving. Share your food and toys, and people will know what God is like. When you see someone who is kind to others, know that God blesses them. God wants kindness to come to them. Care about other people, for God cares about you very much. When you see someone who is gentle and who doesn't hurt others, know that God blesses them. They will always be part of God's family. Tell others that God loves them. When you see someone who tells the truth and is honest with God, know that God blesses them. God loves them and will always be with them. Tell others that we can always trust God. Friends, you are all God's children. Listen to God. Listen to each other. The Beatitudes make a whole new sense to me when I realize it's not something that is inactive, but something that is active. You who gather have been blessed by others. We gather here to give God thanks, to praise God's name, to be renewed and strengthened and rejuvenated, so that we might go forth and become the Beatitudes for others, to be a blessing to others. And when we love others and accept others and forgive others, we're on the right road. We are blessed because we're blessing others in Jesus' name. I pray that we take our feelings, our thoughts, our hopes, our dreams, our sorrows, our fears, and we lay them all at the foot of the cross so that we might be empty, and in our emptiness be prepared to be filled with the Spirit of the living God, who will take us to where we need to be, that others might know the joy Jesus Christ. Can I get an amen? During this time of prayer, it's a time where we speak with God. It's also a time to listen, for oftentimes God speaks to us in these moments of quiet solitude. There are things that are on many people's hearts and in their thoughts. In the prayer request book, there was a request for prayers for Gavin Bachman. Gavin is Paul Bachman and Sandra Bachman's son. He was hospitalized with some health issues, and we ask that you would hold him and the family in your prayers. There are a number of people that are listed on the inside back of your bulletin that in your daily prayers that you might remember them. Remember that prayer is not a stagnant thing that you just sit and offer up words, but that you also put some action into it by picking up the phone, by reaching out through a card, by letting others know that you're thinking of them. And if nothing more, when you pray, you should be reminded that the people that you're praying for are not alone, and neither are you. So let us turn to God in prayer. Holy and gracious one, we give you thanks and praise for the glory of this day. We thank you for all your blessings, for clean air, fresh water, for the beauty of the earth. We thank you for the food that sustains us. We thank you for the jobs and the schooling and the recreation that allows us to make the most of what you have given us. We pray, O gracious one, that you help us to remember how precious life is, that we don't take a moment for granted, and that you allow us to tell those we love how much they mean to us. Remind us that we are never alone, that you continue to make your presence known for us through so many. We pray that you might remind us, especially on this day, but every day, that those people that we've commended to your care have entered into your glory and they are with you. And so if we truly believe that you are everywhere, even here now with us, then our loved ones are here too. May they continue to smile down upon their family and their friends, upon their church, that you might continue to pour out your blessings on all. We pray, O gracious one, that you help us to follow in their example as they share the gospel with us, that we might continue to answer your call to ministry, reaching out to the poor and the hungry and the homeless, praying for the support of those who place themselves in harm's way for our sake, for firemen, for EMTs, for police officers. We pray, O gracious one, for those who are serving in our armed forces, both here at home as well as abroad. Holy One, we ask special prayers for those who are dealing with health issues, for those who are dealing with mental concerns, depression, anxiety, addiction. Continue to send into their lives people who have answered your call to social ministry. We pray, O gracious one, that you be with those who are battling all kinds of deadly diseases. We especially ask that you might hear our prayers, that we might find a cure, a vaccine, a way to end this pandemic, so that we might resume some semblance of normal. Holy One, continue to send into our lives those people who share your compassion with the sick, those who are hospitalized, and those who are dying. We pray, O gracious one, that you continue to hear our prayers for those who grieve the loss of loved ones, that you might continue to make your presence known through a kind gesture or a supportive word. We thank you for opportunities to remember, such as today, and not just those who may have passed in the last year, but for those who have passed many years ago, who continue to bring a tear to our eye and a sweet memory to our thoughts. Holy One, we ask that you might continue to be a blessing to our children as they learn about the Beatitudes and what it means to be a disciple of Christ, that you continue to send into their lives loving teachers and mentors, people who continue to share their life by giving support to the young. We pray that you hear our prayers also for our neighbors, our co-workers, so that we might continue to recognize that we are a community. And regardless of our skin color, regardless of our political background, regardless of how much money we earn, regardless of the amount of education we have, regardless of our ancestry, you have created us all in your image. Help us to recognize that which is sacred and holy in one another. We pray, O gracious one, for our country as this week unfolds, that you might continue to bless all of your people, both those who win and those who lose, to recognize that we are still one nation under you. Help us then to vote our conscience. Help us to continue to be your people. Help us to voice your love for all the world through Jesus Christ, who calls us to be the church. I also pray, gracious one, personally, that you make your presence known for the leaders of this congregation, that you might guide them in the decisions they make for our future, and that we might continue to be responsive to your spirit. I ask that you might continue to bless this congregation as they prepare to gather for their congregational meeting in 2 weeks, that you might continue to help us to work together to proclaim the good news of your love. Now, Holy One, that love shows up in so many ways. And so with those voices of the people that have passed into your loving hands, the saints that have gone before, as well as the saints that are yet to come because of our modeling and our teaching and our sacrifice, we pray the words that Jesus taught. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever.
Amen.
So at this time, I would like to share with you the anthem.
Oh,
because of the support of so many, we are able to continue to share the good news of God's love. We are grateful for this opportunity and invite you to continue to answer God's call of service by responding financially, either by dropping your offering envelopes in the basket in the narthex, if you haven't thus far, mailing a check through the postal service if you're watching from home through YouTube or Facebook, or by using our Tithely app to give electronically. We thank you for prayerfully considering what you are able to afford. And as those gifts come in, are counted, are deposited, and then used for the benefit of God's ministry here at Good Shepherd, I would invite you to join in this prayer of dedication. Thank you, God, for these gifts, gifts that we now return to you. May they be faithfully used for the building of your kingdom here on earth. I have to say that in the 22 years that I have served as pastor here, I so much appreciate the people who I have met along the way, who I have ministered to and ministered with and served alongside. And I can still see people sitting in particular spots. And I can still see the smiles of those when they were happy. And I can still hear the stories of many of them telling me things that children and grandchildren did, or sisters and brothers would do, about how they met the love of their life. I can see some of them laughing, telling jokes, some that I could repeat, others probably not here. And I think some of you know who these people are. I can see people who were curmudgeons and always were a little difficult, but yet they had a heart for God. And I am so thankful to each and every one of you who have shared those precious memories and those precious people with me. There's no greater gift that I could receive than having the relationships that I have built and remember over the years. And whether young or middle-aged or old, they continue to walk with me in my ministry when I go out and visit future people who need to hear the word of God's love. So I, on behalf of myself, thank you, the friends and the family of Good Shepherd, as we continue to be committed to God's purpose. So when I give this benediction, it's a benediction that many of our loved ones have heard. It's odd. I can see people that are still with us but aren't with us today. Philip, putting his hand up right along with me. But I ask that you think of this in the spirit of those who you love, who may never have darkened the doorstep of this church, but who have been blessed because of knowing you, and that you might go out and bless others. God grants us the gifts of service that we have been given through the Holy Spirit, so that we may each serve in Christ's name. And now, may the grace of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, the love of God our Heavenly Father, and the communion of the Holy Spirit touch each and every one of your hearts today and tomorrow and for eternity. Amen. This time, keeping social distance, I would invite the pews in the back to leave first and work our way up. And a reminder to those whose family members we remember today, I invite you to come forward and to take that rose that you place on the altar with you as a remembrance.
What do you want to do?